Drag Race just wouldn't be Drag Race without its lip syncs. Across the years, across the seasons, we've gotten dips, reveals, breakdowns, and stunning lyrical interpretations. But when it comes time to separate the girls from the queens, whose performances really stand out? We asked Xtra readers to chime in with their picks for the best lip syncs of each season, and then we scoured Herstory to find the best of the best. Some of the most memorable lip syncs actually came from the show's earliest seasons, when performance ability actually trumped looks in casting. Season 1 saw Akasha break the dawn to a Michelle Williams song. And Chanel showed her true vulnerability to Whitney Houston's The Greatest Love of All. But the clear season 1 winner has to be Bibi Zahara-Benet versus Angina to Britney Spears' Stronger. An epic face-off, two frontrunners fighting for their lives, and a decision so difficult that RuPaul himself had to walk off stage to finally choose that Bibi had won. Season 2 saw more strong battles, including the incredibly tight fight between Morgan McMichaels and Sonique on Two of Hearts. But it was lip-sync assassin Jujubee who thrilled us the most. Her best performance was against the late, great Sahara Davenport, as the two turned out wildly in different interpretations of Alana Miles' Black Velvet. Juju's emotional rendition trumped Sahara's dance routine and instantly entered the pantheon of iconic lip-syncs. Season 3 had plenty of memorable face-offs, including the sexy and sultry lip-sync by Raja and Carmen Carrera to Straight Up. But our pick for the top slot, and mentioned by some of you on Facebook, is one of the absolute wildest. Delta Work tried her hardest, but Manila Luzon's crazy-eyed, deeply committed performance of MacArthur Park takes the cake. Coming to the end of our old school section, we have season 4's best lip sync, and let me tell you, there is only one choice for the best. It is absolutely the legendary, the iconic This Will Be lip sync featuring the princess and lip sync assassin Dita Ritz. Dita said she wanted to impress the guest judge, the late Natalie Cole, and suffice it to say, she left Natalie and all of us screaming for more. The next 4 regular seasons saw a surge of lip-sync assassins. In season 5, it was Coco Montrese, who had her work cut out for her next to a cast that included Detox, Jinx Monsoon, Roxy Andrews, and her rival, Alyssa Edwards. There were plenty of iconic moments, including Roxy's double wig revealing, instantly classic battle to Whip My Hair against Alyssa. Hey, now they don't know what to do, we turn our back and whip on her. But it was Alyssa's own battle against Coco, where Coco won out, to Paula Abdul's Cold Hearted that stands above the rest. In season 6, the assassin was none other than Trinity K. Bonet. Even when she lost, she won, as she and Adore Delano absolutely stunned in their fire face-off to Paula Abdul's Vibology. But I have to give the edge to another pick of Trinity's from the comments. It was her very first battle against April Carrion to Chaka Khan's I'm Every Woman. Season 7 and 8 featured fewer iconic battles, but the good ones were truly great. There was Kennedy Davenport and Katya's split heavy battle to Katy Perry's Roar. And Layla McQueen versus Nasha Lopez to Lady Gaga's Applause. But it was for season 8 that our commenters across social media agreed as to what was the best. And that had to be the recently departed legend Chi-Chi Devane versus Thorgy Thor on the iconic Dreamgirls ballad, And I Am Telling You. No! You're the best man I'll On the latest iterations of All Stars, the lip-syncing queens are the top gals, not the ones in the bottom two. Without the same fire to avoid elimination, the lip-sync results are often less impressive. Aja and Ben De La Creme's battle to Nicki Minaj's Anaconda stands out in All Stars 3. And Evie Oddly and India Ferris facing off to Ricky Martin's Live in La Vida Loca was the best of All Stars 5. But those lip syncs were the first ones out of the gate. There's something to be said for a later lip sync, one that comes at a really crucial juncture of the competition. In All Stars 1, bottom dwellers Raven and Jujubee, two best friends who had been on the same team all season long, cried for their lives to the tune of Robin's Dancing on My Own. The heartbreaking battle wound up saving them both in All Stars' first double chante. All Stars 4 was the rare All-Star season with multiple great performances. Commenters mentioned Monet Exchange's battle with Valentina to Into You, Valentina's big redemption. There was Monet's big Broadway battle to Come Rain or Come Shine opposite Naomi Smalls. Let me, 'cause I'm gonna be true if you let me. I have to shout out personally Gia Gunn's battle with Naomi to Adrenaline in the RuPaulapalooza. And Manila Luzon's battle against Trinity of the Tuck to Whitney Houston's How Will I Know. Not so quite tough a choice is from All Stars 2. There's one lip sync, and it's a lip sync for your life that is often mentioned among the all-time best ever on the show. You know what it is. We're going from 0 to 60 in 3.5 to Shut Up and Drive with Alyssa Edwards and Tatiana. With a shift to casting more social media queens in modern Drag Race seasons, the performance quality in lip syncs has been a little bit unsteadier. Season 9, however, is a welcome exception. In that season alone, with Peppermint alone, the lip sync assassin of that season, you had battles against Trinity of the Tuck, then Trinity Taylor, to Britney Spears' Stronger. And against Cynthia Lee Fontaine to Madonna's Music. For season 9, though, there is truly only one pick, and it's one that many of you across social media came up with. It has to be Sasha Velour's epic rose petal reveal against Shea Coulee in the finale. The move was so ambitious and exciting, it's no wonder queens have tried so hard to replicate the moment in the years since. Seasons 10 and 12 do have a couple of solid lip syncs, but it's Monet Exchange versus Dusty Ray Bottoms to Nicki Minaj's Pound the Alarm that stands out most from season 10. And it's Widow Von Due versus Jackie Cox to Katy Perry's Firework that stands out most from season 12. Neither, however, had the impact that the best lip sync of season 11 did. It was the single most mentioned by fans across social media. It is Evie Oddly versus Brooklyn Heights, round one. Their gravity-defying battle, double chante earning smackdown to Demi Lovato's Sorry Not Sorry. That could easily be the end of our list. There are a lot of very amazing performances in there. But we can't go without acknowledging our ferocious Queens of the North, now can we? The first season of Canada's Drag Race was arguably the best season for lip syncs ever. It's certainly up there with season 5 and All Stars 4. You've got such epic battles as Priyanka versus Ilona Vurley to Ali X's Hello. You've got Lemon versus Rita Baga to Alanis Morissette's You Oughta Know. You've got a personal favorite of mine, which was Ilona versus Tynomi Banks to Avril Lavigne's Girlfriend. How are you thinking? My personal number one from Canada's Drag Race was mentioned over and over by commenters across social media. It's one of the best lip syncs Drag Race has had in years. Honestly, one of the best in herstory. It absolutely should have earned a double Shantae for these queens because they did Celine Dion proud. It's Priyanka and Kiara to Celine Dion's I Drove All Night. I drove all night. And that's our list. Did we get all of your favorites? Did we miss any? Comment down below if we did. You can also tweet at us and follow us on Twitter at Xtra Magazine and follow us on Instagram at the same handle. Until next time, just remember, Shantae means stay.